The locals were none too happy to see us here. Looks like after the war, they created a veritable technophobic cult here. And its leader managed to trap me in their half-flooded church. I have no idea what they would have done to me had they actually captured me. But with the aid from a woman called Katya, the cultists have been keeping imprisoned here. I managed to give them the slip. Luckily, I was able to avoid excessive casualties in the process. Katya mentioned an engineer called Crest, who's hiding from the cultists in the port. He could help us fix the Aurora and cross the bridge. Now seems to be a good time to pay him a visit.
Artyom, your mech can't handle the repairs alone. Get to the port soon if you don't want us stuck here forever.
Artyom, I took some measurements. There is one hell of a radioactive hotspot between this place and the port. The readings are off the scale.
So you'd better take a boat. We found one and docked it under the bridge. Well, unless you're afraid of the monster. Duke told us over the radio.
Artyom? Afraid? Bullshit! Besides, the monster is just a catfish.
After the nuking, the fallout got washed off into the rivers and settled down as sediment. Catfish are bottom dwellers, so they got...
Artyom! The only reason we're still here is because of you! You need to get to that port! Move it now!
Whoa. to the building's roof! I'll lower the crane for you!
Thank you.
taking cover!
You're pretty amazing, bratuha! That was crazy! Blin, those mutants are pretty hardcore. The villagers are never have a chance against them. You just cut through them!
Well, it's pleasure to meet you. Name's Crest, by the way. Are you from the train? Bet the locals wouldn't even talk to you guys. Open fire right away, didn't they? Of course, those dumb bastards. I've been here long enough to know the drill. They have a cult over there. The dumbasses are hung up on technology having destroyed the old world. So they don't exactly take kindly to smart guys here. And me, well, they were just gonna lock me up until I agreed to go fight those electrical demons of theirs to absolve my sins. Because I was in cahoots with Satan, apparently, блядь. Some Satanist I am. I've been fixing engines and trading all my life. Now I'm moving to the east. Blin, I'm sick of this part of country. There's just nothing to do here anymore. The cities are gone. Bandits, beasts all around. Lots of space across the Volga, though. Plenty of opportunity. So, I came here with my rail car full of trading goods, hoping to make a few sales on the way east. What a fool I was. I was lucky to get out alive. Anyway, since you've arrived, I've been thinking of this little plan I had, never had a chance to pull off alone, but since you guys are also going east... Now, judging by what I could see with my binoculars, it's a miracle your engine is still running. Oh, by the way, take the binoculars. I'll show you where everything is. Look at the bridge first. See that section on top? It should lower if the emergency mechanism still works. Katya from the church should know better. I've never been to the bridge myself. There, to the right, that huge hangar. That's a terminal, Blin. The cult is considered a holy place. Covered it all in graffiti, schmaffiti. There, Tsarfish lived there, you know. Stupid bastards. Even further right, see the building near all those carriages? Used to be a train depot. There's some bandits there now, but the place itself ain't bad. Oh, the area nearby isn't too bad either. There's a good hunting and stuff. I set up several safe camps around there. If you find them, you could rest, fix your equipment. Unless you prefer spending nights at an open campfire. Now, come on, let me show you my home now. Here is my cave. And this is where I live. Not the palace.
What?
Well, here's a bridge. My home is your home.
I made a workbench to trigger one.
If you need ammo, grenades, there's some raw materials here. So help yourself. You can have anything you like. Can't carry all the shit anyway. Come on, don't be shy. Anyhow, gotta tell you, this isn't just a pretty place. I've got a whole lot of knowledge stored up in here. And look at these hands. They know how to fix stuff. You'll never have second thoughts about picking me up.
To buy some smokes from the villagers before the assholes chase me away. Dumb cretins didn't like my life, yeah. I've been banned from the village and the bridge ever since. But I guess you shouldn't start a fight with them right away. They are dumb and brainwashed, so they were probably just scared shitless by your arrival. How dare they thought Judgment Day had come, and right on time, too! You have nothing to fear from them. Yeah. The beasts, well, that's another story, though. Take these ugly mutant bastards from earlier, for example. One of them, it's nothing. But you come across a pack of them, oh, just run. I once had to drop all my shit to just get away, and I consider myself lucky. Woohoo, the motherfuckers are smart. Throwing rocks. Those things hurt like hell. Humans are always worse. Some bandits came here recently? I have no idea what they want. They didn't approach the bridge or the village even once. They just sit there, blять, waiting for something. But I know there are bad news, you know? Now, you could take the zipline down, just hook up and away you go. Villagers say people started going missing when the bandits come. Now you go fishing or something, and you just don't come back. Well, I could go on for ages like this, but your leader wanted something done. Just go on ahead, I'll gather some stuff here. I'll see you at the train!
That huge thing, like real huge, it went straight for us, clanging, shrieking, smoke everywhere. I only had time to say, Lord, save us! And it broke through! We were lucky we got away alive.
That's just hellish, running people over with a train.
heretics. What do you expect? We tried shooting at them, but it would take a cannon to do any damage. So, Father Silentius forgave us for not doing our duty, but still gave us penance for leaving the post, which is another sin. So, why did you get the penance?
Ah, that was my Damashka. She scolded me for boiling water, and I just swore at her. Our Holy Father said hitting her could make our marriage even stronger. But running my mouth like that was a grave sin. Oh, he sent me fishing. With no gun.
Ah, don't you worry. It's a quiet place. Nobody comes here. Not even a mutant, really. The Tartars talk easier from time to time. But we, the faithful, have nothing to fear.
The fish? Yeah, I don't fear, for I hold the true faith. But the fish comes here to feed?
Yes, but the fish would never touch true believers, so no fear there. Of course, if your faith isn't strong enough, then it's another can of worms. The fish feels it and gobbles the non-believer whole. Even the true believer standing right next to him doesn't even get splashed with water. I've seen
it. Oh, Lord, save us!
Okay. Now, will you just look at what the cat dragged in?
A heretic! Lucifer's light!
Hey, turn that off! It's a sin!
Lord Almighty, save us from the electricity worshippers!
Well, I'll be. He doesn't turn his satanic light on us. His gun is holstered. He's a human after all, even though he is a heretic. He has some sense, even. His soul may not be completely lost.
You wish. Do they even have a soul, them heretics?
Look at his armor!
Yeah, that's a work of Satan, all right. I wish our paladins had something like that, though. Of course, blessed by Father Silentius. We'd never have lost the train depot or the tower to those bandits. We'd still have it all, and they'd all be in hell. We'd be cutting them down like dogs.
It is temptation. Temptation by technology and its satanic power.
You're right. But really, damn.
Don't turn this light on here! You'll attract demons!
Turn that off, I'm telling you!
Oh, God, save me and shield me from the enemy's eye and his breath and punish the enemy's servants. We won't yield to temptation. We won't pray for salvation, but we will steel ourselves in faith and accept the fate of martyrs.
Artyom, I heard you call me. It was so great there. But I heard you and couldn't leave you. It's good Artyom found me.
Oh, what is this place?
See the barrels? They're chemicals of some kind. This place is either for storage or it's a dump. And that short could have been put there by the locals to mark the spot.
Thank you, my love.
Oh, okay. All right. So, Artyom, let's pick her up now?
No way in hell. I can walk just fine. I'll just rest a bit and get going.
The old man's probably going seven sorts of crazy now, thinking his precious daughter got hurt or something.
Dad, it's me. My radio battery died. I got it wet. Other than that, I'm fine. Artyom and the guys are here.
Sam, is that you? Thanks for helping find Anna. Now I want you to drag her butt here with extreme prejudice. Time to talk some sense into that brat. Stepan's asking for some too. Trying to get civilians on board. Everyone's gone nuts here.
Head back. Help Stepan persuade my father about letting Katya and Nastya travel with us. Artyom, I am feeling better now. Really, I am.
So, Sam, tell me what the real enemy bases look like so that we know when we see it.
Well, first of all, there are these huge humanoid robots, all plastered with stars and stripes, with nuclear reactors up their asses. Oh, and the food's great. Burgers, fries, shakes.
Nah, I'm being serious. What the hell?
Okay, well, let me be serious, too. How the hell am I supposed to know how they look now? I haven't seen one in, what, 20 years or so? A fence, some guard towers, patrols, buildings. Bases look like bases. Nothing like that around here. We have yet to see anything even remotely resembling one. But if we do, I'll be sure to go say hi. If I can still remember how to speak English.
All right. Don't be mad.
Do you guys really believe you're gonna see any Americans here? I was hesitant at first, but now I think I'm the only American we're ever gonna see out here.
Well, that's fine by me, since we can always talk things out with you, Sam.
Artyom, help us.
We have to go back now, I guess.
Where would you go? Those fanatics would eat you alive.
Well, maybe they... I don't know.
I mean, sure, it's not just about the space. We might have to fight our way through the bridge, and even after we do, we don't know what dangers lie ahead. But still...
And I told him I could help. I'm a medic. I also told him about the bridge, that it could be lowered. Yes, I even told him about the carriage in the train depot. We came all the way here in it. It's very good. We prepared it for the long trip.
Uncle Artyom, please, let us come. I will be good. I will help with everything. I will.
Oh, Nastya, quit bugging Uncle Artyom.
Oh, don't you worry, Nastya. Uncle Artyom will talk to our commander and sort it all out.
Whoa! Uncle Artyom is more important than that scary commander with metal legs.
Oh, darling, you can't say that.
Well, Uncle Miller is the chief here, but he does listen to what Artyom thinks. Doesn't he, Uncle Artyom? I was going to go and get that carriage myself, but no dice. Leaving your post, enemy court-martial, you know the drill. So now, it's up to you and Anna to persuade him.
Will you take us away from here, please?
Of course we will. Don't you worry.
Hi, Artyom.
Gorat, welcome to the crew.
Thank you. We'll let you down. Hey, Artyom. See how it all worked out?
Come here, Artyom. Have a seat. Look, we have an opportunity to cross the bridge without an assault. There are trade caravans going up the river, and the bridge dwellers do business with them. So... disguised as such traitors, we will infiltrate the bridge and lower it. Katya says it still works. They won't be able to stop us if we move fast. And should they try, we'll cross it no matter what those fanatics think. They want blood, they will get it. So now, we only have to wait for the traitor's boat.
Colonel, sir, we can't just leave them here. They will be eaten alive.
Sihan, did you ever try using your head? Do you know where we are going? What we are going to face on the way there? Where, pray tell, are they going to sleep on the Aurora? Atop the coal crates? We Spartans can handle it. But for a woman with a 6-year-old daughter, no less, this is unacceptable.
I'll give them my bedroll and move into the stove.
You will fall asleep and get your throat cut the next day. You'll get guard duty after trying to sleep there.
Still, I know we can't leave them.
Let's just collect that carriage Katya told us about while we wait. We can't leave the child here. And anyhow, how long are we going to sleep in turns for?
Are you starting that again? How? Huh? How are we going to collect that carriage? I'm not taking the Aurora there.
Oh, you don't need it. I have a rail car hidden in a terminal. It can tow a carriage like nobody's business. Artyom and I can go get it and bring the carriage back.
No way I'm letting you go! It'll take us both till morning to finish the repairs, and I can't handle it myself in time!
Okay, have it your way. I'm done playing the monster here. We get that carriage, we take the civilians with us. Artyom, will you handle this?
Listen, Artyom, if the caravan is sighted, drop everything and rush to the port. It's our best chance of traversing the bridge.
Thanks, Dad. Katya and Nastya will be so grateful.
Here, Artyom. It's a breaker for the rail car. It won't run without this. She's a real babe, Artyomich. No two ways about it. We went to hell and back, here and I. So much stuff we hauled, so many tight spots she saved me from. Look, Artyom, since you're going to the terminal, hear me out. It's quite a distance away, and look... if you go at night, there's less of a chance you might run into bandits. They stay at their camps when it's done.
But it's not gonna be easy either, since more beasts come out, and there are also electrical anomalies. The fanatics call them the demons of electricity, so you should think about your options before heading out.
Artyom, Duke is on a mission in that area. He's keeping tabs on the bridge. Reception is bad there. We get mostly static from him. Anyway, if you meet him, he'll update you on the latest developments in the terminal. I bet you've conspired with Anna and Stepan. I care for those two no less than you. But we don't know if what's ahead is any better than the fanatics. I guess we'll have to live and see.